Stucco is one of the most problematic building materials that we work with. It's said between 70 and 75% of stucco in Philadelphia and the surrounding areas fails. This is especially true when it's on top of wood framing. When it's done right, it lasts for a really long time. It's really durable, beautiful, a really high-end finish. Too often though, it's done wrong. We're gonna show you three things that we look for when we bid a project that let us know that the stucco probably wasn't done right. Let us know what you think and check it out. Windows and doors are often the most problematic area of any wall assembly. One thing you can check for really quickly is to see if there's head flash installed in your window. It's not an indication that your window is flashed perfectly, but it's a good indication that they were taking the right steps. Typically, you're gonna want to see your head flashing on the head of your window. It's bent up the wall before the cladding or stucco is installed, goes down, comes out, goes over, and the ends actually have a little dam. So any water that hits the window head, instead of getting wicked back up, it will get kicked out. Any water that finds its way behind the stucco will be able to get directed over the window and away from the siding. We're never gonna keep a wall assembly totally dry. There's always water that's gonna find its way in. The name of the game is letting it dry out. If it can't dry, it'll die. Put me down, put me down. It's pretty amazing. If any insurance companies out there watching, we were able to totally do that scene with 100% AI.
So here's an example of proper head flashing. Now we've already taken all the stucco off, so it's easy for us to get up in here, but you can see the head flashing starts up under there, comes down and is bent over the front or over the top of the window there. You can tell that it's on there. If you just inspect the top of the windows, you'll see that there's something kind of capping the top of the windows. You'll see that there's some kind of bent aluminum on the edge that's meant for water to escape down and away. So if you're not sure if there is any kind of capping on top, most likely there isn't. It should be pretty obvious. Difference in color, difference in material. That's what you're looking out for.
You really don't want to see stucco on a horizontal surface. It's almost always a recipe for disaster. If you see that, that's a really good indication that someone just did something quickly and they weren't concerned about the longevity of anything. So any change of plane that you have should have a really clear way for water to get out. Originally, this bay window was clad in stucco. It was actually clad in EIFS, exterior insulation facade system. Similar principle. It came down vertically and then returned underneath. And what was so problematic about it, there was no way for water to drain that got trapped in the system, entered the system, passed through the wall via condensation. It needs a way on this lower plane to drain out. We didn't have that. If you can see in these videos too, the original stucco, there are tons of signs that moisture wanted to come out. This white staining is called efflorescence. That's minerals being passed through a masonry system and the salts are actually getting deposited on the outside. This is usually an indication that there's moisture and there's moisture movement. Unfortunately, there was so much damage under the stucco system, it wasn't letting enough out. So there should be a really clear weep system where this face stops and this face starts to let water out before they start. In this case, we're replacing everything with siding, partially for budgets, partially because we really don't believe on stucco systems on top of a wood sheathed house. This is a vented soffit. These holes actually let air in to dry wood out and they let moisture out as well.
So if you're a homeowner or someone looking to buy a house in the near future and you see that there's stucco and you want to make sure that it's done correctly, one way that's super easy, you don't need a ladder or anything else, is you can find where the stucco meets the foundation. All you're gonna do is look right under this edge here and you're gonna look for something called a weep screed, a Z flashing, some kind of flashing. You can look that up, you might even include a photo of that right here. What that's gonna do is allow the water to drip out. As the water absorbs into the stucco, it's gonna be able to find a way out and away from the house. It's also gonna allow air to flow up into that space, drying it out. Right now, if you were to look under this edge here, you will not see anything like that. You're gonna see the stucco right on top of the OSB with nowhere for the water to get out, nowhere for air to get inside of there and dry that area out. That's what you're gonna see when you look up under this bad stucco.
Another thing to look for, especially if the stucco is on wood framing and you know it's not brick behind it, are these expansion joints. If you don't see these expansion joints, the likelihood that that stucco is gonna fail goes up.
You know what really grinds my gears? Stucco on wood without a drainage plane. Who does that?
Cladding on the side. You're gonna wanna, God damn it.
It's not hard. Let air behind there. Let it dry out. Why would you just slam up stucco on top of tar paper with no way for the water to come out?
Hello, are you curious about your stucco cladding?
You know water's getting in. You know it. You know it. How's water gonna get out? I don't know. Are you kidding me?
Down with the sickness.
Oh, ah! Hur, hur. It's got that dog in me.